Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of videos I'm doing about MLOps with MLflow. We will work today with projects again, and this time we will use Databricks as a artifact store tracking server. So we are going to review today how to integrate MLflow with Databricks. It's a very common scenario where many technologies are just has been used for doing experimentation and some ML experimentation or data experimentation. And then on, we use a central repository. In this case, it's going to be a Databricks workspace where we log artifacts, models, and all the metadata that we generate with MLflow. So, to start with, first of all, we will create an account in Databricks. It can be in any cloud provider. Just you need to go to try Databricks account. You just set up first name, last name, etc. You don't need to pay anything. You have a 15 days free account in any of the cloud providers. You just set up the details, and you just choose the provider of your preference. It doesn't matter which one you choose. What you are gonna see in this video is gonna work exactly the same. So I choose Azure, and then on once you get clicking Azure, you continue here, and you go to Microsoft Azure dashboard, and here, well, you just choose the resource group, the subscription, workspace name, region. Click here in trial. 14 days free, and give a name to the name resource group name. Review and create, and you will get that one. So once the workspace is created, you have this. Take note of this host URL. It will vary depending on the cloud provider. The only thing that changed is the URL. This is the URL that you will use to access the service from internet. And then on, you can click here and you get the workspace. The workspace is exactly the same regardless that the cloud provider. One note, you cannot use Community Edition for this. For this video, it's not containing the integration with MLflow, so you need to set up a trial account. So just be careful. After 14 days, it will be closed automatically. The next step is just go to the settings here, go to developer, create an access token. Create a new token, give that a comment, and generate, copy. So if you just say lifetime 19 days, after 90 days the token will be expired. If you remove this, the token is a lifetime forever. So take note as well of the token, because we will need both host and token to access the Databricks command line interface software. Okay, once you have this, for now we go to the CLI. And then on, I will pass you all these details in the repo. I post a repo. This part, it was set up with the previous video, the part one, where I just use my local infrastructure and set up this pipeline with the MLflow projects. And then on, in the same repository, I just extended to explain you how to configure Databricks and install the CLI, set up the environment, and run the pipeline, which had some small changes. but we will cover this right away. So we go to the CLI. In this case, I'm using Windows or System Linux to run this pipeline. The execution is going to be in local, and the tracking, the login is going to be in Databricks. We can have as well the execution in Databricks. This will be another video. I don't want to extend and explain all the possibilities in a single video because it will be very long. And also we can have the execution in Kubernetes. So we just download and install the software with this command. Again, you have it on the repo. I will push later on the repo in the so the access to the repository in the description of the video. Export path, export the path where the Databricks is installed, and just to verify that Databricks is correctly installed, execute Databricks minus B. Then on you execute Databricks configure, and then on here you just paste the host. Paste only this part after the HTTPS, as you can see here. We can do it again, and you just copy this part. Okay, let me copy from another. Yeah, copy from here. I have it here as well. Probably you don't see it. But just copy and the token as well. Once you have this, everything done. You can check if you now, for example, wants to verify the connection, just do Databricks, for example, Databricks help. It will give you all the commands. And you can execute, for example, Databricks workspace listl, and this is listing everything that you had in your home and in the root of your workspace in Databricks. So you can write share or users. Now this means that you had the configuration correctly set up. Then now we had our workspace, we had our command line interface correctly configured. The next step is just set up the environment variables. So where is this? Sorry. Here. Oops. Sorry. So you need to set up export these variables, ML flow tracking underscore URI to equal Databricks, Databricks underscore host to the host address, the URL, and Databricks underscore token equal the token itself. This key, which start with DAPI, D-A-P-I, and surname. And if you don't have this, it can happen two things. That in my case, as I have before, the configuration that point to my local infrastructure, it will log into the local infrastructure. If not, it will log in your local folder, in the folder where you had the software. It will create here a folder with ML runs and ML artifacts. And everything that you produce in your code, it will be logged there. So if the configuration is half correct, half not correct, or not completely correct, it will fail. And the last thing it changed is the command. If you watch the previous video, which I did exactly the same that you are seeing here, but instead to log all the metadata of my experiment, of the experiment and the artifacts I logging into MLflow, the tracking server and artifact directory was set up in my local environment in Kubernetes. So watch the previous video because I will not cover now the MLflow components and projects, every single components. I will just run the project. If you want to see all the details, watch the previous video, the part one of this tutorial, where you had the explanation how to create the individual components. So before I was logging here, let me show you how it looks like. No, it's not. Yeah, that one. So in my previous video, I just log here, the same exercise. I just had the four components in my pipeline, the workflow, which is the job which orchestrates the other three, data download, data cleaning, and training. And this is going to be exactly. So I wanted you to see this because you will see that there is absolutely no change regardless where you are logging the artifacts and the metadata. So the only thing that we are pointing to a different tracking and tracking server and artifact repository. So we go to the command line now. We are going to do the execution in local and the tracking server remote. As I said, it's going to be in the user space, and the only thing that changed, you can see here in the previous command, the experiment name is pipelines, and this is the way that it was locked here in my local deployment. But if you are working in Databricks, you have to write the path of the experiment. The experiment at the end of the day is a file, is a link to like a URL, similarly that you have when you point locally to the experiment in the local infrastructure. But in Databricks, you have to point to slash users slash URL of the user that you are using to log in, and slash the name of the experiment. We will run it again. So now change Databricks 2. I change the name of the experiment, and now it will start. You see here there is doesn't exist, and create a new one. Now let's go to Databricks. Let me find where I have it. No, no here, no, 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 no. Now here. Okay, so if you go here to experiments, you see here the three versions I already run. You don't need to have a cluster set up. You are just using the workspace. You don't need to spend money here. So you just log, and you can see here we have exactly the same four components. And once it's finished, the same that in the previous run, we had workflow. This is the job, the run that orchestrates the other three. So we had two parameters, which are the URL of the dataset that we will use for this experiment, and the steps that we will run: data download, data cleaning, and training. If you go to data download, we just get the parameters. This is something that I lock inside the code of my artifacts of my project in MLflow for this component, and then on I also log the dataset here. Let's check if everything is finished. Already finished. We can look data cleaning is another component. We had the data path. You see it's pointing to my local environment. Then I log the length of the final data frame. And in artifacts, I just lock the data frame as well that I produce with my logic. And the final is the training. I use logistic regression with autolog, MLflow autolog. And as you can see, it's capturing everything automatically. You don't need to do anything. You don't need to worry. It's done automatically by MLflow. And here, this is the I don't remember what is that, but so model metrics, this is automatically produced by Emerflow, and in artifacts you can see exactly the same. As we set up autolog, we are automatically logging the model, producing all the metadata that you need to replicate or to load the model in any other environment with your Conda, YAML file, Python environment requirements, the model car, and also as we are running autolog, is also producing these nice plots. Here you have the model automatically logged. And that's it. Pretty simple. This one is normal because MLflow is now integral part of Databricks. It's fully integrated and supported and maintained by Databricks. Before it was a third-party tool, which also started to be integrated. At the beginning, it was an individual library, but after that, I think it was acquired by Databricks, and now Databricks maintain completely the tool. And well, it's pretty easy. If there is a tool which is fully integrated with MLflow, that tool is Databricks. So, and then this is the common scenario where you have a common tracking server and repository for multiple technologies. You can do execution in local, in Docker, in Kubernetes, in whatever SageMaker you want. You just need to correctly set up at the beginning of your job the environment, and obviously have access in case that you are working on the cloud. You need to have access to the VPC where the workspace is running. And essentially is that the rest MLflow is quite good design, and then it will be everything for you. So if you want to see the details of how the different components of the pipelines are done, watch the part one, and then you can compare at the same time how it works with the local infrastructure that I had in Docker in comparison with this setup that where we are using Databricks as again as a tracking server or artifact store. And that's all. Thank you very much for watching as usual. Give me a like if you like the content and you think it's useful and interesting for you or for your work, for your training or for whatever. And share with your colleagues and friends in order to promote my channel. And thank you very much. That's all. Give me a like as well if you like the video. And we'll see you soon. Thank you very much. Bye.